Welcome students, this is a new video on differentiation for the class 12 students of science and arts of Maharashtra State Board. We have already discussed some preliminary concepts in differentiation. In the last video we saw differentiation of inverse function. We have seen the rule for derivative of inverse function there. We have proved that rule, which in short is dx by dy is 1 upon dy by dx. And also we found the derivatives of inverse trigonometric functions like sine inverse x, cos inverse x, tan inverse x and other three. We shall use these derivatives later on. Today we shall practice a few examples on rule for derivative of inverse function. And these are the examples taken from exercise 1.2. So let us see a few examples. So see the instruction. Find the derivative of a function using derivative of its inverse function. So you will be given a function y, like y is equal to fx. Then you first find the inverse function of this function, which is x is equal to f inverse y. Then differentiate this with respect to y, and get dx by dy, which is equal to d by dy of f inverse y. Then after finding dx by dy, use the rule for derivative of inverse function and find dy by dx, which will be found by using this rule. Dy by dx is equal to 1 upon dx by dy. And this is how we can find the derivatives of the functions, which will be written in this section. So y is equal to fx will be given. Take inverse function of that function, find derivative of that inverse function, and using this derivative of inverse function, find the derivative of the original function. So let's take one example. One, y is equal to cube root of x. The given function is just like this, y equal to fx. Y equal to fx is a general kind of expression. We are taking here one particular question, y is equal to cube root of x. So using the simple rule for derivative, we can easily find derivative of y, which is cube root x, as how do you find this derivative? Cube root x is derivative dy by dx. You can write this x raised to 1 upon 3 and then use the derivative of x raised to 1 upon 3 formula, which is 1 upon 3 x raised to 1 upon 3 minus 1 x raised to n's formula. So that can be done easily, but we can't use that technique to find this derivative in this question, because in this question the instruction is slightly different. So we have to go as per this strategy. So first of all, using y equal to fx, find x is equal to. How do you find x out of this? Just take cubes on both sides. So taking cube on both sides, it'll give you y cube is equal to x. You are taking cubes on both sides, y cube is equal to x. And using this y cube is equal to x, now we can write x is equal to y cube. It's the same thing, just I wrote it in this manner. So this was given, we wrote this. After that, differentiate with respect to y. This differentiation with respect to y. So it will give me dx by dy is equal to, the derivative of x with respect to y is dx by dy is equal to d by dy of, right side is y cube. And what is this? D by dy of y cube, just like d by dx of x cube is 3x square, d by dy of y cube is 3y square. D by dy of y cube is 3y square. And then we have found this dx by dy now. Now we just have to find out dy by dx. For that, use the rule dy by dx is equal to 1 upon dx by dy. This rule is proved by us, which is 1 upon, what is dx by dy earlier found? It is 3y square, 1 upon 3y square. Now the last thing we want to do here is write this expression dy by dx is 1 upon 3y square in terms of x. This expression is in terms of y. So we want to finish this answer in terms of x, and for that we have to go back to the previous few steps. Here see, y is equal to cube root x. So I should write this y as cube root x and write it as 1 upon 3 into y square is, y is cube root x square. So we can finish this as, even better answer is 1 upon 3 into cube root x square, you know, is x raised to what? X raised to 1 third raised to 2. That means x raised to, see, x raised to 1 third raised to 2 means x raised to what? 2 by 3. So I should write here x raised to 2 by 3. So that makes it complete. Dy by dx is equal to 1 upon 3 x raised to 2 by 3. Just forget this. This is a rough work. So we found, we were given y is equal to fx, y is equal to cube root x. We wrote its inverse function, x is equal to, so this x is equal to f inverse y, or in this case x is equal to y cube. Then differentiating with respect to y, you get dx by dy, and then write dy by dx is 1 upon dx by dy, which is 1 upon whatever dx by dy you found, 3y square, and 1 upon 3 into 3y square, 3 cube root x square is 1 upon 3x raised to 2 by 3. In this manner, we can find the derivative of this kind of example. We shall see few more examples. Let's take another example. Y is equal to log of 2x minus 1. See, if you remember the steps, we have to find out x from this. Y is equal to log of 2x minus 1. We can find x by, first of all, separating this 2x minus 1. How do you separate 2x minus 1 from this? You remember the definition of logarithms. That makes it clear. See, y, whenever it is equal to log of a to the base b, then you can write this expression as b raised to y is equal to a. B raised to y is equal to a. In the same manner, when the log's base is not shown, it is understood to be e. If you understand this as e, it means that e raised to y is equal to, as per that arrangement, it is equal to 2x minus 1. So forget about this e. For the time being, you can write that and then just leave it. So e raised to y is equal to 2x minus 1. What you want is x. So take this 1 on this side, it will give you e raised to y plus 1 is equal to 2x, which further means x is equal to e raised to y plus 1 upon 2. So I shall write it as x is equal to e raised to y plus 1 upon 2. So that is my first step. From y, I have found x. Y in terms of x was given, that means y is equal to fx was given. We wrote x in terms of y. After that, I have to differentiate this x with respect to y. This is the inverse function of the original function. So inverse function has been found out. Let us find the inverse function's derivative. For that, I have to differentiate the given expression with respect to y. That means I write it differentiating with respect to y, which means x's derivative with respect to y is dx by dy, which is equal to d by dy of the right hand side, which is e raised to y plus 1 whole divided by 2. So d by dy of left is equal to d by dy of right side, which means differentiating with respect to y. Now what does it give you? This 1 upon 2 is a constant that comes out, then d by dy of only e raised to y plus 1 remains. Understand this? This e raised to y plus 1 whole divided by 2 means 1 by 2 into e raised to y plus 1. 1 by 2 is a constant. So constant into function, if you want to differentiate, you can leave the constant out. Then you can move ahead, writing 1 by 2 as it is. Then d by dy of e raised to y plus 1, some rule, d by dy of e raised to y plus d by dy of 1. Out of that, d by dy of 1 will be 0, constant derivative 0. So what is it? D by dy of e raised to y is e raised to y only. D by dx of e raised to x is e raised to x. In the same manner, d by dy of e raised to y is just e raised to y. Plus derivative of 1 is 0, so I need not write that. So answer is e raised to y upon 2. So this was dx by dy. So we were given y is equal to fx. We wrote x is equal to f inverse y. Then we found dx by dy. And last thing is to write dy by dx from it. So what is dx? Dy by dx equal to, using the rule for derivative of inverse function, dy by dx equal to 1 upon dx by dy. And which is equal to 1 upon whatever dx by dy you have found. It is e raised to y upon 2. And that means it is 2 upon e raised to y. And finally, you have to write this dy by dx in terms of x. Now it is in terms of y. So how do you get rid of this e raised to y? In fact, y has to be eliminated and you have to replace it by the terms of x. So go back to the previous few steps. Here you have, see this y in terms of x is written here. Original expression is also fine, but you can use this expression there, e raised to y as 2x minus 1, and write this as 2 upon e raised to y is 2x minus 1. So this is dy by dx for us. Dy by dx is equal to 2 upon 2x minus 1. Let us see another example. Y is equal to e raised to x minus 3. Y is equal to e raised to x minus 3. Again, you can see the strategy of these answers. Y is equal to fx given, you have to find out x is equal to f inverse y. The inverse function of this function has to be found. That means just try to find out x separately. What do you do? Take this 3 on this side. It will give you y plus 3 is equal to e raised to x. Even you want x out. So what do you do in such cases? When you have e raised to x is equal to y plus 3, you want x. Take log on both sides. That will give me log of y plus 3 is equal to log of e raised to x. You can simplify this as x log e, or simply x or x log e, using the rule log of x raised to n is log of x raised to n is n log x. Therefore, it's x log e. X log e is simply x. So x is equal to this repeated log of y plus 3. X is equal to log of y plus 3. That means I write it x is equal to log of y plus 3. Now I have found this step from this step. y is equal to fx was given. And we found out x is equal to f inverse y. This is the inverse function of this original function. Now let's differentiate this with respect to y to get dx by dy. So differentiating with respect to y, I get d by dy of left side, that means d by dy of x, which is dx by dy, is equal to d by dy of right side, which is log of y plus 3. D by dy of log of y plus 3. And what d by dy of log of y plus 3? It is 1 upon y plus 3. Using the rule, d by dx of log x is 1 upon x. D by dy of log y would have been 1 upon y. D by dy of log of y plus 3 is 1 upon y plus 3 into d by dy of replacement of y. You compare this log of y plus 3 with log of y. Log of y's derivative is 1 upon y. So derivative of log of y plus 3 is 1 upon y plus 3 into d by dy of replacement of y is y plus 3. So now you can write it 1 upon y plus 3 into d by dy of y plus 3, d by dy of y plus d by dy of 3. This d by dy of 3 will be 0, d by dy of y is just 1. So 1 plus 0 is just 1. We write just 1. So 1 into anything, that doesn't matter. 1 upon y plus 3. And finally, this is dx by dy. We have to write dy by dx from it. So therefore, using that rule, dy by dx is equal to 1 upon dx by dy, which is equal to 1 upon y plus 3. 1 upon y plus 3. It's just 1 upon dx by dy is 1 upon y plus 3. Which means just y plus 3. 1 upon y plus 3 is y plus 3. And what is y plus 3? Y plus 3 is, y is e raised to x minus 3. You can write y is equal to e raised to x minus 3, or directly y plus 3 is e raised to x. So just e raised to x. So dy by dx is equal to e raised to x. That's how we found dy by dx in this example. So these are the examples where dy by dx could have easily been found directly. If you think about this y, its derivative dy by dx can be easily found. See, dy by dx equal to what is derivative of e raised to x? E raised to x minus derivative 3, 0. So you can find dy by dx easily as e raised to x within one step. But as per this instruction, we cannot do it in this example. We have to find out inverse and then the inverse derivative and then find the derivative of the original function using the derivative of the inverse function. So therefore, we had to take this long route. Otherwise, this answer could have been easily found. Y is equal to e raised to x minus 3, differentiating with e raised to x, you directly get dy by dx equal to just e raised to x. Understood? See this new question. This is question number 2 now from the exercise. Find the derivative of inverse function of the given function. That means you will be given a function y equal to fx, some function will be given. Then you can find its derivative dy by dx. And from dy by dx, you can find its derivative of inverse function. That means dx by dy, which is 1 upon dy by dx. So you will be given y, and you will be asked to find derivative of its inverse function. That means you will be asked to find dx by dy. So just one step more. So you first find dy by dx, using that dy by dx, find derivative of inverse function x, derivative of inverse function. So let's take one example, y is equal to x square e raised to x, y is equal to x square into e raised to x. This is our y is equal to fx. We have to find the derivative of inverse function of this function. So what you do is, differentiate this with respect to x and you will get dy by dx is equal to d by dx of the right side, x square e raised to x. What do you do in this differentiation? You can see this is a product, so derivative is found by product rule. This differentiation with respect to x, x square into d by dx of e raised to x plus e raised to x into d by dx of x square. Product rule is applied, which gives you x square into d by dx of e raised to x is just e raised to x, plus e raised to x into d by dx of x square is 2x. Just simplify this by writing e raised to x as a common factor, and then what remains inside is x square plus 2x. Even x could have been taken common. So this is dy by dx. Dy by dx is equal to e raised to x into e raised to x, and even I shall take x common. It will be x plus 2 remaining inside the bracket. So this is dy by dx. So we were given a function, we found derivative of y, derivative of the given function, but we want the derivative of its inverse function. What we want is derivative of inverse x, that means dx by dy. So just find out dx by dy as 1 upon dy by dx, 1 upon dy by dx, and what is 1 upon dy by dx? Dy by dx is equal to e raised to x into x plus 2. So dx by dy is equal to 1 upon e raised to x into x plus 2. This is the third question in the exercise. Find the derivative of inverse function of the given function and also find its value at the given point. That means you would be given a function, you have to find out its derivative first, which is not asked here, but we have to find it. And then from this derivative dy by dx, find the derivative of its inverse function, that means dx by dy. So find the derivative of inverse function, that means these three steps as we did in the last example. What is more, what is asked extra here is, after finding that derivative of inverse function, also find its value at the given point. That means in these examples, you would be given extra information. This given point will be there, and there you have to find the value. For example, let's have this question, y is equal to 3x square plus 2 log of y is equal to 3x square plus 2 log of x cube. You mean this x cube is together here. Okay, at x is equal to, now this is extra condition, x is equal to 1. This extra condition was not given in the previous example. Now it is given. So what you do extra is find dx by dy at that given point. In this case, it is x is equal to 1. Suppose another example is x is equal to 0, write x is equal to 0 here, and then find its value. So whatever x value they give you, you have to use it in the expression of dx by dy. So like in the previous example, we shall follow the steps. Dy by dx, first of all, y is written here, I shall not repeat. So differentiating with respect to x, I will get dy by dx is equal to, what is dy by dx? Simple case, 3x squared derivative is 6x, and plus 2 into, I may rearrange this, I should have done it earlier, as 3x square plus 2 into log of x cube, you know, is 3 log x, which means it is 3x square plus 6 log x, 3x square plus 6 log x. So the y is actually equal to 3x square plus 6 log x. So differentiating this, it gives you 6x plus 2, that 6 log x is derivative, 6 is the constant, and derivative log of x is 1 upon x. So simplifying this, 6 is a common factor and x plus 1 upon x. That's not all, 6 into, right, is better as x square plus 1 upon x. This is dy by dx. Dy by dx is equal to 6 common, and then x plus 1 upon x is sorted out as x square plus 1 whole divided by x. Now from that, you found this. From that you have to find out dx by dy. Therefore dx by dy is equal to 1 upon dy by dx. 1 upon dy by dx, which means is equal to 1 upon, what is dy by dx? Dy by dx is equal to 6 into x square plus 1 upon x. Simplify it a little bit. This will be x going up divided by 6 into x square plus 1. This is dx by dy. So we found dx by dy. What is the extra factor or extra part in this example? If you remember, we were asked to find out derivative of inverse function of this function at which point? At x is equal to 1. This was the question. We had to find out the derivative of inverse of this function at x equal to 1. So in the end, I had to find dx by dy, which is the derivative of inverse function at x is equal to 1. So this is the dx by dy. If you put x is equal to 1 here, it will give you 1 upon, right, this x as 1, 6 into 1 square plus 1. And then simplify this. Just replace this x in dx by dy by the given value. And it will give you 1 upon 6 into 1 plus 1 is 2, which is 1 upon 12. So answer is 1 upon 12. So one extra part is there in this example. Question number 3's examples are like this, where you have to find the dx by dy in the same manner as you did it in case of question number 2, but that extra substitution of the given value, x is equal to 1, sometimes it is x is equal to 0, sometimes they may give you x is equal to 2, whatever value they give, just write that value in place of x in the last step. So in this manner, you can practice few examples from question number 1, 2 and 3 in the exercise 1.2. Remaining examples we shall discuss in the next lecture.